You hear me?
Yeah.
Alright, yep. I'm ready.
How many cast tokens do you have?
Two.
Alright, good. Use Archmagus.
Alright.
And so, at level one, you're going to want to start Health Pot, cast token. You're also going to want to put a mana pot in the deck, so, like, first back, you'll sell one of the cast tokens, buy the mana pot, and then you'll buy... Do you have Sage's Ward?
Yeah.
Okay, so you use that. How many lesser healths and minor casts do you have?
Two each.
So I guess do minor casts... lesser health.
Alright.
And then your second item, Crystal Conduit. Do you have minor shocks and basic manas? Like how many of each?
Yeah. Minor shock, I got 7. Basic manas, I got 5.
Alright, 2 minor shocks and 1 basic mana.
Okay.
So, the reason I put 2 Minor Shocks in here, I don't know if you 100% know this, but tank heroes technically, or typically have like 40-something or higher, like base resist. So, basically when you put 3 points of pen in here, you're going to be penetrating everyone for like the whole early and mid game, usually. Unless they start building. Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, if they're building, you have to build, like, spend a lot of points to penetrate anyway, so this is just, like, really good. And it gives you the mana. So, next, I'm going to have you get Staff of Adamant.
Okay.
And put Divine Health, or wait, it could be Divine or Greater Health, it doesn't matter. Then 2 Major Casts in here.
Alright.
But if you're behind, like... So let's say the other mid laner, by the point that you're buying the Staff of Adamant, they have, like, more card points than you. You'll put a second Greater Health in instead of a Major Cast.
Alright.
And then after that, I'm going to have you get a Blink Charm, just so you can get out of fights if you have to, or you can engage fights and get out. But I probably wouldn't worry about doing that. Just use it for, like, escapes, you know, because teams like to ditch each other all the time. So... With a Blink Charm, late game, eventually you're going to have to sell the Crystal Conduit to, like, and you'll be keeping the Sage's Ward and the Blink Charm as low-cost cards. I'm going to have you build an Elder Mage Amulet next. Yo, peace out, Aram. Have a good one. Do you have Celestial Health? Okay, put one of those. Major cast. And you'll be getting this after your Blink Charm. The reason you're using a 4 cost health is to, like, and because the Blink Charm's a 5 cost instead of a 6 cost, it'll offset.
Even it out.
Yeah.
Alright.
How many cards is that? 1, 2, 3, 4. Put a Mind Flow in. This is a really good card just to grab if you ever need, or if you ever have like 3 points to spend and like you'd have to start like a brand new card, you'd get Mind Flow instead because it gives you equivalent of like 6 points of value. You're getting 1 point of mana, 5 points of cooldown reduction, like whenever you're not under half mana, so it's pretty good.
Should I try to get Mind Flow before I start building the 12 and 15
yeah.
Point.
Yeah, okay. That'd be good.
Alright.
Yeah.
How many cards is this? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so do you like to auto attack a lot in team fights?
Yeah,
All
I
right,
guess.
good. All right, we're putting a whirling wand in here next.
All right.
Gonna have you do one major kinetic and two major cast.
All right.
Do you have a second Elder Mage amulet?
No.
You have another Staff of Adamant though, yes? All right, so we'll build that, and we'll put two greater health and one major cast. So your full build will be Sage's Ward, Blink Charm, Elder Mage Amulet, Staff of Adamant, Whirling Wand, and then another Staff of Adamant. Are you at 32 out of 40 cards?
Yep.
All right. So level one, well, do you usually get insta-Qs?
Nah, I guess it might take like
All right, I'll go over this first then. All right, so at level one, you're gonna want to take Speed Gate because even if a jungler comes to gank you and if you have Speed Gate, like 9 times out of 10, you're just gonna be able to run away. You want to place the Speed Gate like right on top of yourself or like right next to where you're going. So, like you can just get that speed boost to get under your tower. You don't want to push the wave at all early game. Unless your jungler is in the enemy's jungle, what there probably won't be like early game. So just try to only last hit, try not to use abilities on wave until you hit level 5, then you could drop your ultimate and go back to base. But you can go ahead and queue up now.
All right. Says estimated time 6 minutes.
Seems good.
So what if they build a lot more armor?
Oh, whoa, I forgot about that. Good call, good call. Okay, so. I don't know. I feel like. Yeah, you're gonna have to figure this out and put someone in there. So if they build way more armor, you're gonna replace one of your staffs with adamant, like whichever one has more damage in it, with. You have another crystal conduit, right?
Yeah.
All right, so add a second one and then do focus shock, advanced mana.
All right.
All right, so that's if they build like. That's only if they build, I'd say if three or more people are building like energy armor, that's when you'd grab that. If there's just two people or one person, like I wouldn't worry about that. But yeah, I guess you're gonna fit it in there, like no matter what. But yeah, if no one's building energy armor, you don't really need pen. Shit, what did I miss? I saw what I missed. One second, guys. Wait, why did this not update?
So my final cards would usually be Elder Mage, the Ward, Blink, the two Staff of
Freestyle, thank
Adamant,
you so
and
much for the
Whirling Wand.
sub. Thank
If
you.
they don't build armor.
Wait, what? Yeah, if they
My
don't build armor,
six.
you just want that other Adamant Edge.
All
Or, I
right.
mean, Staff of Adamant. I always call him Adamant Edge. Oh.
All right, I'm in draft.
Nice.
Never mind, someone didn't ready up.
Seems good. Shoot, I'm just gonna eat this sandwich.
Right now I'm in draft. I think someone on my team wants to play mid.
Make sure you get mid. Just tell them you can only play mid and you only play gadget. Yeah, there's like 2 or 3 minute delay. I can still give him tips though, to make the game go into his favor. Well, how did you get 6 replays per scroll? I don't know. My resolution. So I won't be able to give you like live like information, but I'll be 3 minutes behind. I'll see everything you're doing and I'll try to give you advice to correct what you're doing and like play better.
All right.
Are they giving you mid now or?
Looks like it.
Gadget only mid, boys. Can't play anything else. Team is good. Must be nice, Ken. I'm fucking crazy. No breaks. Well, I mean, I kind of did take a lot of time out of a break today, but I'm not taking whole days off yet.
These guys are talking about something about Agora. GG.
Seems good, man. So have you played a lot of Gadget before?
I've tried it like a few times, but
okay. So generally in team fights, you'll always want to like throw your mines on cooldown. As long as you're throwing it like directly at the target, generally it's gonna stick. It's actually like one of the most broken abilities in the game, probably, just because it's really easy to land. But usually you want to target someone who has less HP. You definitely don't want to throw it at someone who has energy armor. After your mine's on cooldown, you'll want to throw your slow on like either the front line. Yeah, usually on the front line, whoever's like in the front of the fight, just so they can't move as much and they take way more damage. If you're going to go in for an ulti, huh?
So you're talking about the slow?
Yeah, usually you want to throw it on whoever's in the front. If you're going to go for an ulti, though, I would say usually you want to wait for someone on your team to land like a hard CC, like a stun or a knockup, then just ult that person. After you ult, you'll want to use the slow if you have it up. For your speed gate, you'll usually want to save to like either give yourself a lot of mobility so you can't be hit by like a ranger, or you'll want to save yourself for a ranger and just run away from the fight with it. Try not to use it too much like during the fight unless you have to. All right. Yeah, thanks, Jerry. Gotta wait like 2 minutes to spectate him. Played against four stack team 3 times tonight. Yo, Gwang, I'd just say like after you queue a game, like take a 5 minute break. There's no way you'll get queued against them again. Like if you see someone twice in a row, like take that break. Or if you just had a rough match, take a break just so you don't have to go against the same people. So like in casual right now, there's a low chance. Yeah, there's like no way we'd queue against a silver account on our mains or in like any of our accounts, I feel like.
Believe in me. Believe in the Kamina who believes in you.
Good night, everyone. Smiley face.
Yo, Maze. Thank you so much for the $10. Yo, good night, man. Gonzo, thank you for the follow. Here we go, boys. Here we go. I'll have music on after I'm done doing this. Yeah, basically told them to play safe early, so there shouldn't be too much fighting here.
Are you watching the game right now?
Yeah, yeah. I just got in. How far are you in game?
5 minutes and 40 seconds.
How many minutes?
5 minutes.
Alright. Yeah, I'm 3 minutes behind. So, like, yeah, your jungler came in. Like, that's like the only time you want to go aggro in this lane. But I did notice your jungler came in, like, on a minion wave. I'd almost just say, like, don't even, like, assist him unless he needs, like, you to help him escape. Because you never want to gank during a minion wave. Like, he ran right up in the minion wave and started hitting Iggy. It was not good. Other than that, I would say good job with using your mine on the minions, because when Iggy's pushing the wave, like, you don't want the minions to go under tower. You want them to be, like, just outside, like you had them. If you do notice, like, when your enemy backs, you want to start pushing the wave really hard, but Iggy already had it pushed, like, really hard, and you're only level 2, so you really can't do that yet. But in the future, yeah, you just want to push it really hard. I would say probably just let the minions go under your tower versus, like, taking a lot of damage, though. Before level 5, mid lane is, like, boring, I feel like. Yo, if your team's pushing, you can't do anything as jungler. Like, you can hardly ever do anything. Really good job with the turret clearing. So yeah, I do see you're trying to, like, kite the minions around. I wouldn't suggest doing that too much in the mid lane. Like, probably just let them go under the tower, it's alright. Because when you're kiting the minions around and the enemy opponent's up there, I know he's not level 5 yet, but if he was level 5, he could, like, definitely go on you. Yeah, good use of your ulti. So that Iggy, like, invested more points into mana than health so far, so he's actually, like, a really good target. Like, if you could, like, request your jungler to gank your lane, it'd probably be, like, a good idea. But obviously you gotta make sure you deward him first, before you ask for a gank. Because the Iggy's had wards before you. He might not have more mana than health at your point in the game. Oh, and after, like, once the game hits 10 minutes, you want to make sure that you don't have the wave pushed towards your side. Like, you're always going to want to have the waves, like, on the enemy side so you can roam as a mid laner. I know it's hard to push against an Iggy, but Gadget's definitely, like, one of the heroes that has an easy time pushing him. Because you definitely want to have roam advantage. Because if Iggy gets, like, the chance to roam and gank, like, mid-game, you can really just turn the game into his side. Really good ulti. Just a lack of follow up from your team. Yeah, the one thing I did notice, like, so you threw your ulti out at like 8 minute team fight. You needed to try and get your drone out there faster to slow.
Alright.
Like, it just took too long.
Use that, okay. So I try to use,
Use, like, right after you...
Before the ult?
No, you, like, right as soon as your ult's, like, pushed and out there, like, you want to get the slow out there, like, on somebody. In there, like, instantly.
Alright.
Because it'll make sure they take more damage from your ult.
Yeah.
I mean, technically you could do it first, but, I mean, you just want to make sure you get the ult off, more or less. Because the ult lasts longer. Yeah, when you're against an Iggy, try to save your speed gate until their ult is finished, if they're ulting you already. Because a knockback can push you away from it. There's a lot of knockbacks that can just, like, deny you of using your speed gate. Make sure you're using your drone that slows to clear wards. If you land it on top of a ward, it one-shots the ward, basically.
Alright.
Yeah, I think Gadget actually has the best ward clear in the game because of the range on that ability. And the safest ward clear. Yeah, so there Iggy's starting to build some energy armor, but Like, at the point that I see, like, you already have more pen than he has armor, so shouldn't be an issue. Yeah, because that Iggy is just throwing down wards everywhere. Like, most of them on your left side. You gotta try and pay more attention to the minimap, because I see here that the enemy's Countess was getting chased, like, all through your jungle. And if you had collapsed on your blue jungle, she would have died. I don't know if your teammate pinged it or anything, but yeah, it's definitely worth a rotate if they're like in your jungle and it's only one person running around.
I think he might have pinged. I need help. When I get the mind flow, should I also try to get the blink charm with it?
If you have enough for blink charm, just grab the blink charm, I'd say. Mind flow is like a scenario where you only have 3 points, you buy it. So when you're in your jungler, we're killing that Iggy, I would say try and get your slow on him, like, way earlier. Like, you could have landed it way earlier in that fight. Like, I might even say, like, use the slow before, like, the mine in that scenario, just because your jungler wasn't... Like, you could have landed it before the jungler even got there, then he would have got extra autos off. What killed Iggy? Oh wait, I already saw that, I'm stupid. Oh man. You couldn't focus on a game while someone giving you tips for 3 minutes to go? I mean, I'm gonna upload it later to YouTube also, so... I mean, this guy's playing, like, really good. Like, there's actually not much room for advice for me to give him, because... Like, he's playing really safe, like I told him to. There's, like... If you're playing safe, there's not as much advice I can give you. But... Like, you don't want to play aggressive in the current. You never want to play aggressive with travel mode. It kind of sucks. Like, you can definitely go aggro. It's just like, on gadget, you just land poke, and if your poke sticks, eventually you might all in. His team's doing, like, really good this game too, so I mean, there's just like not that much room for him to do better.
I keep messing up my seek and destroy drone.
Yeah, it takes practice. Like, sometimes I click it like too early. You just gotta be patient, wait for it to be on top of it. Just because you're learning how to use the Seek and Destroy, I would say try and aim it more towards, like, the target. You know, like, so just, like, aim for a spot on the ground that you're trying to get it to go to. So in the future, whenever Countess ults you, make sure you ult, like, immediately, like, as soon as she's on top of you. Or, like, even before she ults you. Because then while she's ulting you, she'll take damage from it. Oh my god. He doesn't really have any abilities up, or I'd tell him to go and like play aggro if people do that stuff, but yeah, I would almost say, like, don't be afraid to ult in fights, like, before CC goes down if you see, like, a lot of enemies grouped up. That way, like, if your team does go in for the CC, like, they'll get more, you'll get more damage off. If they don't go for the CC, like, it's still, like, a good zoning that'll get them off your team.
Alright.
Yeah, basically just don't be afraid to ult early, or, like, first. Wow, that was really good, so you can destroy into that tier 1. Rip that Grim, though. Alright, I see what you were talking about with the Seek and Destroy. So, the ones in the jungle are really tricky. So, I would normally say just aim, like, above them if there's, like, obstacles in your way. But, like, if you aim above them in the jungle, your Seek and Destroy might just, like, chill on top of the trees. So, for, like, a aggro clearing wards, like, I'd just be careful. Like, don't do it unless you have your team around you.
Alright.
So, like, use it to clear all the wards on your side of the map. So when you're kind of just, like, running around in mid lane, like, you should have just went over to black buff sooner than you did. Or, like, went to clear, like, some of your jungle camps. I mean, I know your jungler was doing them, but I mean, it doesn't hurt to take like one camp here and there. So I do want to point out one thing. So let's say we are on Monolith. So the speed gate's purpose is going to change completely once Monolith comes out. You'll be wanting to use it before like team fights and shit. But I mean, obviously in this map you just got travel mode. Your speed gate will be travel mode on Monolith.
Alright.
If you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a coaching session right now.
Well, we won.
Oh, the game's over already?
Yeah.
That game was like a stomp.
I felt like I didn't really have to do much. Just rotate.
Yeah, I mean, that's all you really have to do, and your gadget was pretty good. Like, you didn't have any, you didn't do anything bad.
We had 17 kills and 3 deaths.
Yeah, so many assists. Do you have any questions?
Not sure. So whenever I'm not doing anything, just if I can, clear a white camp, I guess.
Okay, so if your lane's pushed up and you got nothing better to do, you have two options. You can either go to the white camps in the jungle, or if one of the other lanes isn't pushed out all the way, you can go over there and help them push it out. Like, if they get mad at you, just tell them to group up and go and kill somebody afterwards, you know? Like,
yeah.
You just want to, like, farm really hard. You definitely want to do your best to practice on dewarding with your Seek and Destroy, but that's going to take some practice.
Yeah, yeah. Also, how often should I be trying to get blue buff?
You should be, like, trying to get every blue buff after 12 minutes. Like, there's no reason that the jungler should be getting him after that point. I mean, you do have a Grux. He is kind of mana hungry. I can understand him taking it. But, I mean, if you trust yourself enough to actually, like, carry, and you're actually... Well, I mean, like, you were against an Iggy that game, so you didn't have much time to, like, leave your lane. But, yeah, typically you'd want to go, like, get blue once your lane's pushed up, and then rotate to other lanes. But, yeah, like, when you're against an Iggy, it's just rough to find time to rotate or get buffs.
Trying to think of what else I did. Yeah, and I guess.
Yeah, it's you did pretty good. You even ulted Prime. A lot of people don't know how to do that. You'd be surprised how many gadgets I see try to like start a team fight while Prime's still dying. Like when they've got like one of the best secures for it.
Yeah, I was actually, when I got there, I was about to put it, but then I noticed that it probably wasn't low enough, so I decided to wait a bit for.
Yeah, if you notice it's going down real slow, I'd wait till 10%. Otherwise, I'd just throw it down at 20 and just use, like, all your abilities on it. Yeah. And if any, like, melee enemies try to steal, they're going to be taking damage anyway, so.
Yeah. Well, thanks, I guess. And,
yeah, now you got an awesome also, deck, too. What were you going to say?
For the deck, since I have, like, 4 extra cards left, should I probably have a 9-point card that I could get rid of for a 12-point card later?
You could either put another 6 or a 9. Yeah, it would work. Like, maybe even turn one of those admin edges into, like, a 9-point. Like, it wouldn't hurt. It would definitely help your mid-game curve. Right now, like, from my point of view, the game feels, like, so snowball-y. You don't even need, like, the 9-pointers. Oh, it's so weird.
So I guess just get better at the drones.
Yep.
Maybe... work on using the drone and all at the same time.
Yeah.
And yeah. Alright. Thanks.
Yeah. You can also like spam like all your abilities at the same time. So like the biggest like combo to do with your abilities is probably like tossing the sticky mine and the drone, like one right after the other.
Should I do the drone first?
I mean, it really depends on the scenario. Like, if you have allies coming there, I'd say, like, throw the Seek and Destroy out first. Otherwise, throw out the Sticky Mine.
Alright. I guess I'll see you in stream then.
Yep. GG.
GG, see you.